Capper woke up drenched in a cold sweat. He just had a terrible dream, but already the details were slipping away from him. He'd been here in Kludge Town, he remembered, and there was fire and Chummer. Chummer. Capper's eyes rapidly darted towards the other bed, but his breathing slowed once he saw his friends lying there, his chest slowly rising and falling. He was all right. And if Chummer was all right, then everything else was all right too. Because Chummer was everything. Capper had never really had a family, never really had friends. But when he'd met Chummer, all of that had changed. Suddenly, he'd had someone who was loyal, steadfast, and always by his side. Chummer didn't abandon him when things got tough. He didn't sneer at Capper when he made a mistake, or abandon him because he was too high maintenance, or because he liked to steal pretty things instead of food sometimes. No, Chummer was someone special. Capper bit his lip. All this because of one little nightmare. His thoughts had a tendency to spiral out of control, especially when he thought about Chummer. He really ought to go to bed, but whenever he closed his eyes, he saw vivid images of the fire again that made him shudder. Without meaning to, Capper's eyes flickered back to the gray cat. His heart beat a little faster. He didn't want to be alone tonight, and he didn't think that Chummer would mind, not when they were so close. A little nervously, Capper swung his legs over the side of the bed, paws hitting the floor. He crawled over to the other small bed and pulled himself onto the ratty old blanket they found inside a trash can one day. He froze when he felt the other cat stir, waiting until the kitten's breathing slowed before creeping closer, nuzzling under the blanket and curling up beside him. Something about feeling Chummer's warm body brought a silly smile to Capper's face. It just felt safe. Capper? A mumbled whisper sounded in the room as Chummer blearily squirmed next to him. Capper suppressed a whimper when Chummer moved away from him in his fidgeting. What are you doing here? It's a little cold tonight, Capper fumbled for an excuse. You know, your bed's a little thicker than mine, and I was just wondering if... Sure, Chummer flipped around, his whiskers brushing Capper's cheek. Yeah, you can sleep here if you want to. A joyful purr escaped Capper's muzzle before he could stop it. He reached up to clamp a paw over his mouth, but he realized from Chummer's slow breathing that the other cat had already fallen asleep. The smile once again rose to Capper's face, and his tail thumped softly as he nestled in closer, sighing with relief. Everything was going to be all right. As long as they were together, everything would be all right.